A Life by Charles Dickens. Audiobook 16x38. It is destructive to herself. He went on to say that he hoped it could be explained to each woman who presented herself for their assistance that she is degraded and fallen, but not lost, having this shelter, and that the means of return to happiness are now about to be put into her own hands. Women might come straight from prison, where prostitutes were commonly sent, but each one must choose for herself to come to the asylum, and want to be helped. His idea was to begin with about 30 women, and he expected they might fail with as many as half of them. His hope was that those who stayed the course could be restored to society and even become virtuous wives. He was especially interested in the possibility of preparing them to emigrate to the colonies, Australia, South Africa, and Canada, and thought the government might give recognition and aid to such a scheme. Failing government aid, he hoped that good people might be found to take them into service. He invited Miss Coutts to entrust him with any share in the supervision and direction of the institution. I need not say that I should enter on such a task with my whole heart and soul. 32 And although he was not yet in a position to start on the scheme, he meant every word, and he continued to write to Miss Coutts with further ideas and suggestions from Switzerland. On May 29, Dickens dined with Forster, who accompanied the whole family as far as Ramsgate the next day. This time the Dickens caravan consisted of 6 children, Anne, and 2 nurses, Roche the courier, Dickens, Catherine, and Georgina, and the same dog, Timber. At Ramsgate they took the steamer to Ostend, then a river steamboat up the Rhine, a voyage that must have taxed the vigilance of the nurses. They reached Strasbourg on June 7, went on by train to Bâle, and there fitted themselves into 3 coaches for the 3-day drive to Lausanne. On June 11 they were at the Hotel Gibbon, and after an intensive search for somewhere to live, Dickens took Rosemont, a house small enough to fit into the great hall of the Pesquiere in Genoa, he observed, but delightfully placed on the slopes above Lac Leman. There were enough bedrooms for all of them and guests, a small study for him, with a balcony overlooking mountains and lake, and the garden was full of roses enough to smother the whole establishment of the Daily News in, he assured Forster, pressing him to come out and join him in reading and smoking in the many bowers scattered about the grounds. 33 No sooner had he arrived than he also began to plan to run over to you in England for a few days in November, should his writing go well. 34 But he could not get going with his writing because the